Hello, everybody. Welcome to our talk on assessing environments against cloud-native security best practices. We are going to be talking about some work that Pratik and I have both done in the CNCF TAG security group called the Cloud-Native Security Controls Project. So really quickly, who are we? So I'm there on the right. My name is Jon Zeolla. I am the CTO and co-founder of a company called Seiso. We do security consulting stuff, and I'm based out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I'm a huge fan of open source, and that's why I took up leading the controls project. It's kind of the short term for the Cloud Native Security Controls Catalog. I just consider that the controls project, and I'm also a SANS instructor, so I do some instruction on cloud native and DevOps things.
Myself, Pratik Lotia. I'm a cloud security engineer at Reddit. I'm helping to keep the deployment secure at Reddit from a cloud and Kubernetes perspective. I'm based out of Denver, right near the mountains, do a lot of hiking there. And again, I'm a big fan of open source as well, and I do contribute to several projects within the CNCF ecosystem. I also run the local CSA Colorado chapter with the Cloud Security Alliance, where we do monthly meetups on talks, we have various technical sessions. So if you're based in Colorado, please hit me up after this. This is a quick look at the things that we'll be talking in the talk today. This is the agenda. We'll be dividing this into two phases. Phase one is the work which has been already accomplished and completed. And the phase two is the work in progress and a roadmap looking forward. So can I do a quick show of hands? How many of you are in the InfoSec security side of the role? A few. And then how many of you are on the compliance and the auditing side? A couple, yeah. So, you know, a lot of us since CNCF TAG security started, since everyone has been doing Kubernetes security, we've been trying to accomplish a lot of best practices and coming up with what's the best way to secure our ecosystem. The biggest challenge here is how do we convince our auditors and the compliance team that, hey, we are actually following the right set of controls and our system is compliant to the security best practices. Interestingly, you know, ever since TAG security started, you know, we've come up with a lot of white papers and reference architectures as a community. So we have like the Cloud Native Security white paper, we have the software supply chain white paper, the serverless architecture white paper, and we keep getting questions on that, hey, we are somewhere here in the journey to securing our Kubernetes workloads, and now our compliance team is throwing a lot of buzzwords at us, you know, ISO 27001, SOC 2, FedRAMP, HITRUST, PCI, and they're asking us reports on whether our Kubernetes setup is compliant to that. And the challenge is, you know, these frameworks, the language is challenging and difficult to understand for traditional security engineers, and we don't know how best to answer the compliance team on whether we are following the guidelines and whether our system is compliant or not. So with that, you know, we have the CNCF controls working group where we have a set of goals that, you know, we started with to accomplish based on the problems that we've been seeing around this. The main idea here is that we want to be assessing the existing controls in the cloud native security space and come up with a standard and unified audit framework which allows engineers to map their security architecture to the existing well-established standards and, you know, output it in like machine readable format so it can be automated as well. In terms of phase one, we have like a standard set of controls mapped out ready, and we have mapped it to the NIST 853 standards. So, you know, the typical old meme where we say, hey, we have a set of kind of controls and standards, but we need one more like universal standard which covers all. So it's like, hey, now we have 15 competing standards. So that is not something that we try to do. We have not come up with like yet another standard. What we've done is we've taken the existing standards available within the cloud native security ecosystem, such as the security white paper and the supply chain security white paper. These are the two major white papers that we've targeted around. And the idea is to be, a lot of this white papers are in terms of paragraphs and a lot of information on what you should be doing. So the idea is to be providing this in terms of a checklist along with a categorization of where exactly this fits in your deployment. So with the existing work that has already been completed, we have a set of roughly 200 controls from these two white papers, and this is now available in Excel format, you know, the format our most of our compliance and audit team loves in, as well as the Markdown format. And each of these controls have a assurance level and a risk category defined. This helps you to prioritize which controls you want to be targeting first. And then along with the set of controls, we have provided some guidance around the implementation as well. So say for example, secrets should not be stored in, you know, certain Kubernetes resources, then the guidance is, okay, this is what you should be using. Either you should be using the Kubernetes secret objects or more importantly, using something like a secrets manager for better security. So this is what the mapping looks like. We have the controls defined in terms of categorization, whether they fall under like storage, deploy time, runtime, securing the artifact itself, and they provide details on which white paper they've originated from and what exactly is the control being defined. And then the second part there is mapping to the 853 controls. So each control in the white paper has been mapped to a set of controls within the NIST framework with details on like, you know, exact identifier like CM2, SI7, so that compliance and audit team can easily identify which control is being met and which NIST control is actually being met by a security control. The idea is to be mapping this to, you know, a lot more standards as well. And we are definitely looking for more people to join us. Or if you have feedback on the existing work done, then please find us later and we'd be happy to have you in the working group so that we can have your expertise to map these controls to a lot more frameworks. With that, John, for the phase two.
Yeah, thanks, Pratik. So what Pratik was talking about was what we've done so far, right? What we've done so far is take those white papers and distill it down into a list of about 200 things, did a little cross-mapping, a little implementation guidance, things like that. And that's great, but that's really just a start. So what we have done recently is kicked off phase two of this project, which we expect to take much longer to accomplish and may not ever be finished. And we have a kind of a goal statement for this new phase, right? We're trying to assess the control status of cloud native environments and share the output in machine readable formats. So that means we are looking to automatically perform assessments of runtime environments or to assess the evidence that might have been collected during a build process or things like that and identify whether or not you are doing things that are recommended in these white papers. And the real goal is to make compliance toil at companies that use this framework kind of look like that, right? Toil is one of my favorite terms, and I use it a lot. No, nobody want, it's not a positive term, right? It's not a thing that we want to be doing. We don't want to toil, right? And so we know that there will be ups and downs. There will be spikes. You'll have an audit. You might have some additional toil, some paperwork, some bureaucracy you might have to do. That will always exist, but our goal is to kind of reestablish a new baseline towards the bottom there, right? So we want to get compliance toil down to a more manageable level, and at the same time, improve our security observability of these environments. So as we're automating these different bits of evidence collection and reports that we can do, we want to know about our environments better. We want to actually make the security posture of the companies where we're doing this better. And so how do we get the toil related to compliance down and the observability about your security environment up? Well, that is by assessing these controls in your environment and then sharing that output in a machine-readable format so we can map together. So that's a lot. And so we tried to narrow down the scope of this project, and I don't think we succeeded because our scope is currently all of the CNCF projects. So that's fairly broad, right? There are a lot of different ways that we're going to be looking at implementing this, and we're in the very early stages of that. This is what our project looks like right now. We manage everything in open, as you can expect for a CNCF tag group to do. We have some things done, some things in progress, and some things still to do. We have a lot of design work ahead of us and implementation. Our goal is to begin doing a few different proof of concepts of this assessment and build on the shoulders of others, and to also collaborate with other projects. There are lots of projects within the CNCF that are doing different levels of this sort of an assessment, and then there are projects outside of the CNCF which are assessing CNCF projects for this sort of a work. Our goal is not to reinvent the wheel. We want to go to where that work is happening and improve it and make it better. That will likely result in us pushing some of our changes upstream into different frameworks. Those frameworks could be other tools. It could actually be other compliance frameworks themselves. So working where, if you can see, you probably can't see that, but on there, there's things like collaborate with the CIS, collaborate with CSA, collaborate with NIST. There's a lot of different collaborations that we're doing on the benchmarks and the frameworks themselves to continually make those better, as well as assessing these runtime tools, these CNCF projects at runtime for compliance or evidence or things along those lines. So that's pretty much the story. That's where we're going. Here is our call to action. So if you are interested in collaborating and doing any of this sort of work, I'd suggest going to the CNCF Tag Security Issue 845. That is where we are tracking all of this phase two work. There's everything you need to know in that issue regarding when we meet, how we meet. We meet on a standard Zoom chat. We have a channel in the CNCF Slack, Tag Security Controls, so feel free to jump in that and ask any questions that you have. And there is a talk that I wanted to give a shout out to that is going to be happening on Thursday at 11 a.m. This is, has anyone heard of Guac? This was just kind of released. All right, yeah, just a couple. This was just kind of released. I think Google did a blog post on it recently, and there's been a few others. It's another tool, one of the collaborations that we have, and something that we see as a potential place to identify whether the evidence collected is the evidence required for an environment, and if people are following these best practices. So definitely check that talk out. That's going to be interesting, and they're going to have a lot more than 10 minutes to talk with you all about that project. That's it for this lightning talk. Were there any questions from the group? Yeah. Can I get a microphone up here? Thank you.
Hello. Thank you for this talk. I think this is the work that you both are doing is very relevant to the work that we have also been doing in the policy work group, because what we did last year, this is the Kubernetes policy work group, is we published a white paper on policy management and, you know, how you represent best practices as policies and get to a more desired configuration state, et cetera, right? And then this year, what we have started embarking on is how do you apply that to achieve business goals such as regulatory compliance, right? So I think that intersects very well with what you are doing. So we should definitely chat. So we have a maintainer track on Thursday, where we are actually going to be talking about our thoughts on how to apply that to compliance. So let's collaborate. I think that's all I'm saying.
Yeah, that sounds great. 100%. Yeah, we've been finding as we talk more about this, there's a lot of people working on this, and I'm not interested in 15 new solutions to this one problem. I would much rather have everybody kind of piling on in one area, kind of like we did with Kubernetes. Lots of people collaborating and making Kubernetes better. Let's make this solving this problem better together as well.
So are you doing this in the context of any specific work group or any...
Tag security.
Tag security. Okay.
Yeah, so at the CNCF level, kind of broader.
Okay, because the policy work group is a sub under that.
It's under the.
So we are in the same groups, okay? So let's talk. Thank you.
Yeah, 100%. Thank you. Great. I think we might have time for one more question. One more. All right. Anybody else? Yeah, back there. Just 1 second.
So it would seem likely that there are situations where there are multiple configurations at the nuts and bolts level which could satisfy a higher level, vaguer compliance. How do you handle those? Do you like say these are the three ways you could do it, or do you pick one? And then my other question is, as versions are constantly changing, you have to like redo this every time a new version of one of your covered projects comes out? I feel sorry for you.
Yeah, there's a lot of work to be done here. So there's not only versions of the software that we're assessing and the software we're using to do those assessments, but there's also versions of the white papers that we're basing these assessments off of. So the Cloud Native Security white paper has version 1 and version 2 out, and version 3 is in the works. So we are, one of the other things that we're doing is care and feeding for this mapping that we've already done, and we have version 1 done, we have version 2 in review. We also have feedback on version 1 in review, and we are working with the version 3 of the white paper as well to collaborate with that. So there's versions of the white paper, versions of the software, so all everything is version pinned as far as those assessments go. And then your first question was, the white papers are necessarily broad. There may be many ways to accomplish the control that's defined in those white papers. How do we do it? Well, we don't choose. We don't pick. This is the only way to do it. We're not kind of that opinionated. Instead, we're saying there are many ways to do it. This is one of them. This and add another way to assess compliance. And there are likely going to be lots of ways that you could achieve compliance that this project would not identify as necessarily compliant. So we're not going to be making a compliant, not compliance assessment. It's more so likely compliant, or we don't know, right? So we're going to start with a very like uncertain assessment to start. Yeah, that's where the mappings and things like that come in, and that gets really difficult. I'll just say that there's a lot of work going on right now in the mapping space because different organizations perform mappings differently. So we did a mapping to 853, CIS does a lot of mapping, CSA does mapping, and the methods that those mappings follow are all different. So there's like composability, there's set operations, lots of different ways that mappings could be accomplished, and how strong those mappings are depends. So that's kind of just where we are as an industry. So great. Thanks, everybody.